Today I am going to introduce you with one more type of microorganism called fungi. Let's see what are these fungi. Fungus is any member of a eukaryotic family. Eukaryotic means an organism which has a nucleus. The nuclear material is inside an enclosed nucleus. So these organisms are called eukaryotes. And fungus is a type of eukaryote. And the different types of fungi which we can see in our day-to-day life are like yeasts and molds as well as mushrooms. So they form a separate kingdom, and the study of these fungus is called mycology. So you must have heard about black fungus nowadays. In newspapers and in news bulletins, you must have heard about black fungus called mucor or mucor mycosis. So this is a structure of a mucor. You can see the mycelia, the thread like things, and the ball like things are the conidia, which contains spores. Spores of these mucor funguses are very light. They can travel from one place to the other place very easily. So they are highly contagious. So let's see what is mucor mycosis. It is a commonly known black fungus. Even before COVID, it was present, and in immunocompromised patients, it used to cause infections in various parts of the body. So in COVID patients also, this is affecting a lot of people because their immunity is already down because of COVID infection. So mucor mycosis is one of the common fungal infections in many immunocompromised patients. Now, mushrooms. Mushrooms are the useful type of fungi. So you will find different types of mushrooms, like button mushrooms, which are used in our daily food by many of us as a source of protein. So they are a very rich source of protein. Then there are other type of fungus. They are called yeasts. So this is a structure of a yeast. You can see single cellular elliptical cells. So these yeasts are useful in fermentation, and the bread which we manufacture is prepared by using yeasts. So some basic information about fungi. Fungi can be single celled, as I told you, like yeast, or complex multicellular organisms like mucor. And they are found just anywhere. They can grow in any type of habitat, but mostly they live on land or mainly on soil or plant materials rather than in sea or fresh water. A group of fungus called decomposers, they grow in the soil or in dead plant or matter where they can degrade those materials, and they are helpful in recycling of carbon and other elements. Now some fungus are parasites in various plants and animals. They can cause mildews, rusts, or various types of cankers. Very small number of fungi cause diseases in animals and in human beings also, like athlete's foot, ringworm, and thrush. Then mouth infections like candidiasis and mucor mycosis of eyes, mouth, and various other organs. So there are some useful fungi like penicillium. So this is a structure of a penicillium. These are the green colored mycelia, and you can see that they form a green colony when they are grown on a agar plate. So these produce penicillium, which is an antibiotic to treat various types of bacterial infections. And apart from penicillium, there are cephalosporins, beta-lactam antibiotics, then griseofulvin, which are also produced by different types of fungi. Then what are the other uses of fungi? They are used as an important source of food, particularly a highly rich protein source. So like mushrooms, which I told you. Then some yeasts are used like Saccharomyces cerevisiae in making breads. And fungi are good decomposers for recycling of carbon. So penicillin and cephalosporins, these are the antibiotics which are produced by fungi. Then how you can protect yourself from fungal infections like mucormycosis? So clean and hygienic environment is must to avoid any type of infection. Fungi are not different. Then regular use of antifungal agents where there is a risk of fungal infections. Avoid places with hot and humid closed conditions. So these are the places where these fungi grow very fast. And eat always fresh and cooked food, and don't store breads for long time. You may not see with your eyes, but fungus may be growing inside the bread. So thank you very much. If you like this information, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to receive notifications. Write in comment box if you have any feedback and suggestions. See you in the next video. Thank you.